Hey everybody, it's your boy MCE Mazin coming at you with another TV FGC news spot starting right now. For our first story, Kirby Fighters 2 is coming to the Nintendo Switch, having been announced this past Wednesday. It is a party-styled fighting game similar to Smash Bros. The roster boasts 22 characters from many different Kirby variations to King Dedede and Meta Knight. It has a battle mode with the typical solo and team battle, and also stages that are interactive in its environment. There's also a story mode and a single-handed mode, which is basically survival mode, but has a limit of 9 battles. Items are also in this game, similar to Smash Bros., and are themed to Kirby's particular universe. One thing that sets it apart from Smash is that the life meter isn't based off getting the player to a high percentage, but decreasing the player's health to 0% for the victory. Kirby Fighters 2 is available now on Nintendo eShop. For our next story, Xbox has released information on its external hard drive options for its next-gen systems. Xbox confirms that USB 3.1 will be plug-and-play compatible with its next-gen consoles, also confirming that 3.1 will be able to store next-gen games. This is great because many can make the transition well to the new system with previously owned external hard drives. However, they do give incentive to use their newer hard drives. They announced they have partnered with Seagate to make a custom 1TB storage expansion card. It's designed using the Xbox Velocity Architecture API to deliver the exact same consistent gameplay performance of the internal SSD. Also, backwards compatible games will see significant improvements in the load times due to the next generation technology. Now that's some great incentive if you want to get the full next gen experience. Also, from their Q&A section, it's confirmed that you won't need to transfer any game over to the system as it can be played straight from the hard drive. Now with all that being said, the price is $219.99. That's a pretty high price, especially when you think about the actual Xbox Series S system is only $80 more expensive. So it's basically like buying another system. So that could be a turnoff for many people. With all this new info coming out from Xbox, including the purchase of Bethesda, Microsoft is really showing itself strong this next generation. Tell us what you think of the storage in the comment section down below. And for our last story, game developers who have worked on various projects from Skullgirls to Indivisible to Scott Pilgrim vs. the World, the game, have come together to form the game development studio Future Club. Their message is that they want to make games that are for the future and create games that inspire people how games did for them. They stress that they are an employee-owned and believe in open and honest communication with peers, partners, and players. Now it's great to hear them stress their openness and communication, as this is something that the FGC and gaming communities in general really desire from developers. It also has to be great for the employees to now be working in a great positive environment with a good fresh start from how we've heard how hectic work environments can be. Tell us how you feel about this in the comment section down below. Well everybody, it's that time again. It's the end of this week's TV FGC News Spot. As always, make sure you like, share, and subscribe to let people know about what we're doing here on TV FGC News. And as always, make sure you leave your comments, questions, and concerns in the comment section down below. Somebody will read them, but not me, of course. Why? Because every comment left lets me see into the future and the deepest, darkest secrets of the people who leave them. And I'm afraid that that is just too much responsibility for these broad shoulders to bear. All right. Well, thanks again for watching this week, people. We'll see you next week. As always, it's your boy, MCE Mazin. Love, peace, and hair grease. And we will see y'all next time.